Hi friends, today in this video we'll try to understand the significance of angular velocity or angular frequency, that is omega, which we regularly use in our calculations in electrical engineering. Let us start from the basic fact that every electrical wave, that is sinusoidal wave, will be having a particular frequency f in hertz, and every rotating body will be having a particular speed that is standardly given in revolutions per minute. But in our calculations, say in phase angle calculations, we will be using theta equal to omega t equal to 2 pi f into t, and in power calculations we will be using power equal to torque into omega equal to torque into 2 pi n by 60. What are we actually doing? Why are we multiplying 2 pi here and why are we multiplying 2 pi by 60? There is something like conversion, like scaling. We are scaling something. What is the exact meaning of this? To understand this, we need to start from the basic fundamental equation of physics, that is work done is equals to force into displacement. Here, for a rotating body in machines, let us take a circle with radius r. Since the force at every point will be acting perpendicular to the radius, let us take the constant force magnitude as F. Here, if this force moves the point on the periphery of the rotor through a distance d, let's say the angle be theta, here theta will be in mechanical radians. Since the rotor is physical body, the angle will be in mechanical radians. The angular distance d can be written as radius into angle theta in radians. This equation will become as F cross R theta. This is nothing but my F cross R dot theta. Since force is always perpendicular to the radius, this will become as the torque tau into theta. To define power, which is nothing but the rate of change of work done, we need to take the derivative of the work done. This will give me the equation like this. Power is nothing but torque into d theta by dt. Since d theta is in mechanical radians and time is in seconds, this will have the units as radians per second. So to calculate the power, we need to define the speed property of the rotor in terms of radians per second. That's how we use in our calculations. But in practical, the tachometer gives you the reading in terms of revolutions per minute. So we need to convert, manipulate the n in terms of radians per second. How do we do this? To do this, we just do some manipulation. That is, let's say n revolutions per minute. One revolution in the sense, the rotor is making a complete angle, which is nothing but my 2 pi radians. So let us substitute, one revolution is 2 pi radians and 1 minute is 20 seconds. This will give me as 2 pi n by 60, which is in mechanical radians per second. So we can use this mechanical radians per second in our calculation. This is defined as the angular velocity omega. That's why we use speed n by multiplying it by a factor of 2 pi n by 60. Now, coming to this, let us define frequency. Frequency in hertz says 1 hertz in the sense 1 cycle per second. It means the electrical wave is taking 1 cycle within a time of 1 second. Here 1 cycle in the sense 2 pi electrical radians. Electrical radians, that you need to remember. So 1 cycle can be replaced by 2 pi electrical radians per second. Since we are calculating theta, which is nothing but electrical phase angle, we will be multiplying the required time with the angular frequency to get the required phase angle. If 1 hertz is equivalent to 2 pi electrical radians per second, f hertz is equivalent to 2 pi f electrical radians per second. This is what we are terming as angular frequency. Now, the important thing you need to understand is that the angular frequency omega and the angular velocity omega are both the same. The basic difference is that in the units. To understand this, we need to understand something. Let us say, as you know the basic equation, the speed of the rotor is nothing but 120 f by p, where p is my number of poles of the rotor, right? Let me substitute this n in this equation. What do I get? I get as omega is equals to 2 pi into 120 f by p by 60. This will give me as 2 pi f into 2 by p. Here, since it is in mechanical radians, this is also in mechanical radians per second. That you need to understand. So, we have the basic equation as mechanical radians and electrical radians are related as electrical angle is nothing but p by 2 into mechanical angle. This equation specifies 1 radian of mechanical angle will be equivalent to p by 2 radians of electrical angle. So, we need to substitute here to convert it into electrical radians. If we convert, this will be giving me as 1 mechanical radian will be equal to p by 2 electrical radians. So, what I will be getting as 2 pi f into 2 by p into p by 2 electrical radians per second. This 2 by p and p by 2 will be cancelled. What I will be getting is 2 pi f electrical radians per second. This is nothing but my angular frequency. This is what the significance of angular frequency. This is how we need to correlate the angular frequency and angular velocity to understand its significance in our calculations. Dear friends, to understand any subject better, we need to link it together. If these are my topics in a subject, we need to find the link between each topic and we need to connect them together to understand the subject as a whole. And to find these links, we need better guidance. Believe me friends, in this whole universe, we can only obtain the better guidance by our own experience. So we need to learn more and understand better. Thank you friends. I hope this lecture will give you a better idea in understanding omega. Thank you.